So first of all, we heard today how Tank got his nickname. How old were you when he came in the gym? How old was he when you met him?
He came in the gym when he was 7 years old.
You remember him?
Yeah.
What was he like as a 7 year old, Coach Kenny?
He was spunky, man.
Which means what?
Like a terrier running with a Saint Bernard compared to the rest. He was spunky, you know? A lot of any general.
So seeing him becoming one of the biggest names in the sport, definitely on my pound for pound list, what does it mean to you guys who've been with him from day one?
It means a lot, man. It's history. It's already there. It's going to be there for the next 100 years. We always look him up. You know what I mean?
You know how you know? You know how
it's good to be a part of it.
You know how you know somebody going to get there?
Yeah.
But you just got to see it for yourself. But you know it. You feel it in your heart that he going to get there.
Mm-hmm.
And then when he get there, it's like, you just got to sit back and pinch yourself like that.
Is it here?
Yeah,
okay, let me ask all three of you guys. Line up the top five 135 pounders in the world in order. One through five.
TFM, he's definitely on the list.
Okay.
Definitely on the list.
But who's number one?
35. I like Devin Haney, but he's moving up. Devin Haney's moving up. I like Devin Haney.
Okay. Also, Tank, he's 35. He got a 35.
Tank is number one.
Yeah. Okay, Tank's number one.
Number one.
Who's number two? Jeff Teofimo, Lomachenko.
Well, Teofimo just beat Lomachenko, so
Then
I put Lomachenko.
Ryan Garcia, Devin Haney.
Ryan Garcia.
See, they do nothing yet. That's what people missing.
Ryan Garcia, I don't have him there just yet.
Not yet. He's potential. He had potential. Cool. Devin Haney. Devin Haney, he did win a belt.
Yeah.
He's there. He's there.
But it's another guy. What's the guy named that treacherous dude? What's his name?
There's one more out there. Spanish kid, I think.
Yeah, I forgot his name.
They mentioned his name here. He mentioned his name here.
Real, real tough guy. Undefeated. Yeah.
He got a coach on that card.
Who are they talking about? Who's number one?
A little more. He's 35, but he's 30.
There's Linares at 35. There's Fortuna at 35.
Not Fortuna.
I don't know his name.
But it's a deep, deep division.
Yeah.
The one got knocked down, probably got back up. And one, the outbox dude.
Oh, the young kid.
The young kid.
Just fought this weekend.
What is his name? What's his name?
He still got a little weight.
He got a ways to go, but I think he's good.
He's good, but
you're talking Xavier Martinez.
Yeah,
got it.
He still got a ways to go.
Yeah, he got ways to go, but he showed a lot of heart. Yeah.
He did.
We're talking about guys that's in that spotlight.
Like telling someone they have a good chin is not always a compliment. That means you get to hit too much.
Exactly.
But he did his thing and he won. So let me ask you this. I know we never do this because Leo Santa Cruz is all on your mind. That's all you want. Leo. Would you want then Teofimo, Ryan? I heard a lot of talk of Ryan Garcia.
You know, I'm going to tell you. If it don't make dollar sense, it don't make sense.
Ryan's a big money fight.
Then that makes sense.
Yeah.
And that's real because at the end of the day, we don't know how this pandemic is going to be. You get what I'm saying? So if the opportunity come across our desk, that's the decision we make.
A lot has been said about Tank's power. Kenny, you do mitts with him. Tell me about the biggest punch you ever took from Tank.
It was a body shot.
Did he drop you?
He didn't drop him, but his punches compared to other fighters, it penetrates. Some fighters just got their thumb.
I remember someone said penitentiary. The penitentiary.
Yeah.
His
put it in him.
I'm just saying because he's a fighter, but his punches penetrate.
What Kenny's trying to say is we got guys that's bigger than Tank, heavy than Tank.
Yeah.
Kenny feel it through the pads. I even feel it on my hands. Like, yo, this joke is punching.
It's God given. You don't teach.
You can't teach that. It's something he was born with, you know?
So what do you think happened Saturday night? Kenny told me 7, right?
About 7, he's going to retire on the stool. In the corner.
He can get you 1 to 12. I'm looking for him to have a great performance.
He's not looking for a knockout.
I don't want him to look for a knockout. The reason why I look for knockouts might not never come. I want him to put in a great performance where the world will say that Tank is that guy. That's what we're trying to prove. We're trying to prove that, yo, when you sit down and watch Gervonta take Davis box, do what he do, you want to be in front of the TV or you want to be at the fight. That's what our whole goal is.
That's the difference between me and Calvin. He like to see you get beat up. I want to see you get
beat up. You know what I want to see Saturday night? I want him to send a notice out to all everybody to 135 and 130.
A message.
A message.
Right. You know,
you've been served.
Deontay Wilder told me once, I don't get paid for overtime.
That's right.
Quicker to fight over, less punches you take.
No, but that's true.
Yeah.
But let's see in history.
Yeah.
Fight and look for a knockout. Guess what happened?
No, I ain't saying
it's true. No, you're right. You're right.
He just hit.
There he is right there.
But this is Santa Cruz. He's a Mexican fighter. He said he's going to take the punches.
You know what they always say?
Tyson said, everybody got a game plan to hit him out.
We all, you ever been driving down there and something happened? You got a detour, right?
Hey,
that's how the fight game
is. You see how we go back and forth. So all this looking forward to see what's going to happen that night.
Exactly.
it's going to be a big event.
They always say, go ahead.
It's going to be a beautiful event, you know, something to remember.
Yeah, and it's history already because of the pandemic.
However long the fight lasts, it's going to be exciting.
It's going to be a top five all-time fight.
Yeah, it's going
to
be
top five.
We're trying to get the fight of the year.
Yeah.
Are they going crazy in Baltimore right now? Are they excited?
What I'm saying, I hope Tank become that crime stopper. Shut the city down.
Like Pacquiao.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. When Pacquiao fights, there's no crime.
Yeah. Shut the city down. Everybody sitting home watching the fight in the club. I want everybody to come out the club like they just watch a karate movie. They be like, yo.
Yeah, one person I was thinking about this morning was Baby Frank, because he was always there. He was always in camp. A great guy from Baltimore. Yeah. Unfortunately, passed away.
All that's running on our mind. I was saying, you know, when we get to where we got to get at after scale is, you know, this fight is for Baby Frank, to tell you the truth.
Very humble.
We're just trying to stay humble and don't get too emotional.
Yeah, that's true. So, focus. Weight's good. Coming down. Tank told me he could fight tonight.
He could fight tonight, yeah. He could,
yeah.
And he's happy, smiling. That's not usually when fighters make weight, they want to bite your hand. Like, no, they're just in a bad mood.
Good.
But Tank's smiling, he's good, he's happy. Yeah. And he gets on a scale tomorrow morning, and then once that, it's on.
Yeah, that's the first fight, y'all.
That's the first fight, and then comes the second fight.
You always hear me say, Tank make the weight. It's a fight.
What do you think of Brian Custer today?
Come on, man! Why are you gonna do that to him? Put him on the spot
He always do stuff to see what's going on.
he
trying to get that inside.
He like to stir the pot up a little bit. Stir the pot up. Just work it, Elie.
You ask tough questions, but you do it in such an elegant way. No one could get mad at you. If I ask the same question, I'll get slapped.
I'm asking the questions that people want to know.
Correct.
You know what I mean? If I didn't ask those questions, people say, well, why didn't they ask this? Or why didn't they ask that? And I think they're all pertinent.
That's
so
true.
You know, that's kind of what I do.
So I'm going to let you in a secret.
Yeah.
Coach Kenny told me that Leo is going to quit on the stool around 7.
That's good stuff. Wow. That's all right. Well, I'm going to mark that one down.
And Coach Calvin said 1 through 12 could happen in any round.
That's a like we're in the political season. That's a politician answer there. That's like a really good trainer there. Like a really good trainer. That's good.
We have seen it. If you go look at his knockouts, it's between 1 and 12.
Between 1 and 12. You're right.
But Calvin, correct me if I'm not mistaken, Tank had a second nickname. Because when I met him, his nickname was The One.
Yeah.
He used to sign his autographs, The One.
When he first started, they tried to call him Rambo.
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 I said, man, what's wrong with you? You've been Tank since you was a baby. He rolled with it.
A couple fights.
He came back and said, man, my name's Tank. Everybody said, that's Tank.
Why Rambo? Where did that come from?
I don't even know.
They told him when he first came out that he had to change everything up from being an amateur going to pro. And I said, man, let me explain something to you. Don't look at your YouTube followers. You already got them. You're going to change it from Rambo. I said, when they type your name up Rambo, they ain't going to see Rambo. You type your name up Tank.
They'll see you.
And he's seen it.
That's true.
He's seen
it. It sticks. There he's chilling.
Yeah.
Somebody got a haircut. I didn't recognize him.
Yeah. No.
looks clean. He looks shorter now.
Yeah.
But it was a very good camp, very disciplined.
Yes.
It was a lot of work, a lot of the Vegas heat, the gym, the sparring. He was sparring guys 78, 178, 154.
I'm like, dude, you could sparring before I even got out here.
How many sparring partners, no names, but how many of them did he drop?
I don't even want to say.
He was talking like that?
Yeah, we ain't gonna go into that. I'm gonna tell you, we had a lot of.
One of them, goodness gracious.
I mean, he dropped one guy in the corner that was just. It got so bad. I'm not gonna say, but it got so bad that we had an altercation between two people because one knew that the fighter was hurt, and they tried to make it keep going. But
you
can't.
Yes, I know. You gotta be responsible. Don't let your ego come in. If someone's hurt, hey, he's hurt.
So you know he dropped a lot of guys,
and we kept it quiet.
Yeah.
No, I know. That's why I said no names. I don't want to embarrass anyone, but I just know.
But I want to say thank y'all. For the help that they did and what they did to get us to this point.
Definitely.
Make sure you sit in front of the TV because you know you had something to do with the work you're going
to
put in.
And don't go to the bathroom. Don't go to the kitchen. Don't look down at your phone. Don't text. No texting. No tweeting. It's exciting and it's big. And 10,000 fans in a pandemic is a beautiful thing. It gives hope to people because this bubble is no joke.
Yeah. Oh, this bubble is no joke.
Someone told me it's like the penitentiary the first day.
I felt it.
They knocked on the door, put the food, and
ran. Yeah, here you go.
Hey, I call it the hole.
The hole.
Those that know.
Yes, of course. Isolation.
Inside a jail.
But safety first, so we understand.
And that really got me because I was in another. Bubble, you moved around a little bit more.
Yeah, it was more flexible.
We couldn't even go away. Bring this bag
lunch. Bag lunch in a brown box.
But it's okay. It's a little sacrifice for a great cause.
No. But we understand. We have to keep the fighters safe, trainers safe, everybody around us safe.
And that's it. And when they faced off today, what went through your minds? It demeans fights here, that's it.
That's it. It happened.
It's the first time they faced off? Did they ever meet?
Yeah, in person. Virtually, yeah. I think they did, but this first time.
No, that don't count.
That don't count, as I said.
I didn't even.
It made it happen. We got all the way here to get the face off, you know. And it was a real face off. It wasn't like that.
Yes, I said.
This is a real face off.
This is not my bag. I gotta stress that. Hey,
give it to 40.
6'9".
Hey, 40. He said, come get this. He said, try to hold it first.
Oh. He said, this is not my bag. Because Kenny be leaning on the kid.
I don't. Hey, kids today. I've seen LeBron.
That's like a briefcase.
That's why I wasn't holding it like that.
Do you see LeBron James? LeBron James walking with the little purse?
No, I didn't see it.
So there you have it, another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter at Seckbach, and you can follow me on Instagram at Elie Seckbach.